الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وآله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد، I know that there is no question, any important question has an answer in the Quran. Anything that we don't have access to it, you will find the access, if needed to be known, in the Quran. Nowadays, of course, there is a big campaign in media, in all means, against Allah. Against Allah. You see, when I hear somebody says, Allahumma a'izzal Islam, I don't feel good. Al-Islam is always Aziz. Al-Islam is the laws of universe. You will never find any law of the universe is going to collapse. Everything is valid and solid. That is Islam. I need not say Allahumma a'izz al-Islam. And even the story, this is something of side product. We learned early in our childhood that the Prophet ﷺ made a dua, Allahumma a'izz al-Islam bi Umar ibn al-Khattab or bi Ahad al-Umarain. It's weak. It is not authentic. I just want you to know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is his deen. Allah is Aziz, his deen is Aziz. So I want to say that we see the war plan is against Allah. So consequently, it goes against man, human beings. Otherwise, why are these children killed? And you read in the Quran in Surah At-Takwir something which is very important to know and feel. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. They used to bury the child, the newly born child, alive. The live baby, newly born baby, is buried. Why? And they call it maw'uda. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask those people who are mushriks, why did you bury this baby? وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. And Allah says, وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ مِنْ إِمْلَاقٍ وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا أَوْلَادَكُمْ خَشْيَةَ إِمْلَاقٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that it is haram to kill a baby or a child because of anything of worries of risk. Then how do you see that killing hundreds and thousands of children every month? Every day there are children killed in different areas of the world. Of course, sometimes you have a feeling oh, we can do nothing. We cannot, because if we want to fight, we cannot fight. The enemy is dominating all the means of war. They will win, we'll lose. You read in the Quran, الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. The Quran tells us that wherever we go, we'll see some people who are agents to the kafir. They try to publicize everything of intimidation in our hearts. They say to us, there are a lot of plans against you. O Muslim, you should surrender, give up your Islam, or give up some matters of your deen in order to make it. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم. But a good Muslim, when he hears that, or he reads something of threats, or watches on the TV or whatsoever, what happens to him? Look at the Quran. Pay attention to what I'm saying to you, quoting from the Quran. الذين قال لهم الناس, when people say to them, there are people who are planning against you, so you should be aware of that and you should be surrendering, you should surrender yourself to these powers. Submit yourself to these powers, otherwise they are going to destroy you. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا. Because of that threat, because of that sort of media, because of that sort of publications, they realize, the Muslim realizes, that this is the righteous road I am taking. Because a Muslim never thinks, if he has good knowledge of his deen, never thinks that his road to Al-Jannah is a very well asphalted road. No, it has lot of obstacles. أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَنْ تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةَ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا. Do you think that you will go to Jannah without having similar to what happened to earlier generations, that they were touched by every difficulty and every hazard until the messenger and the followers of the messenger say, when is the help of Allah coming? The help of Allah is always very close to you. So here, when a Muslim sees that people are his enemy because of being a Muslim, فزادتهم إيمانا. Instead of being intimidated and afraid, they understand, no, no, we are taking the righteous road, and our righteous road is what we have of those obstacles. فزادتهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله. As we are متوكلون, we gave Allah our power of attorney, and He does everything for us. We are not owners of ourselves, nor are we owners of our properties. Allah is the owner of everything. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله. الله is enough and he is the best to be our وكيل. What happens? فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل. A Muslim never loses, because if he is having hard time, that is the best credit for a Muslim in the hereafter. If he loses anything, Allah multiplies the investment a lot for him. If he lives and Allah gives him the help to defeat the enemy, then again that is another image of how a Muslim, after being victorious and triumphant over his enemy, what sort of life he will have. The Quran continues the same ayat in Ali Imran. What goes on of those media works or politicians' work, any way that Muslims are under a threat? Allah says, you know what happens here? إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ. Who is the wali of the shaytan? Those munafiqeen and the enemies of Allah are the closest, and they are the allies of the shaytan. إِنَّمَا ذَلِكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ يُخَوِّفُ أَوْلِيَاءَهُ. The shaytan comes to you, says to you, don't ever make this secretary of state angry. Don't ever make that ambassador angry. Don't ever make that etc. angry. This is the way يخوف. إنما ذلك الشيطان يخوف أولياءه. فلا تخافوهم. Don't ever be afraid of them, because no one has any power in hand. We read in the Quran, لا قوة إلا بالله. So then we understand something of what goes on. The last point of my speech today, I was telling some of my students, I say, when I was a teenager, I used to go to the masjid. The imam then was of his 60s, more than 60s. I see him and hear him repeating what Allah says, لَيْسَ لَهَا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ كَاشِفًا. What happens of hard times and difficulties and the humiliation to Muslims, oppression, Muslims are under certain difficult circumstances, he used to say, shaking his head or nodding his head with what he recites of the Quran, ليس لها من دون الله كاشفة. I myself now, I don't know what will happen, but I know one thing, that nothing of the plans of any sort of enemy means anything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah said, they plan, إنهم يكيدون كيدا. They plan and they make their plan, but Allah says, وأكيد كيدا. And I have my plan. But فمهل الكافرين. Give these enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala time. Give them short time. فمهل الكافرين. أمهلهم رويدا. Give them short time. I'd like to say, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says about the Muslim, "Inna amrahu kullahu lahu khair." Anything happens to a Muslim is good, because we are under test. The dunya life is a life for test. It is not a life for joy. Joy is in the hereafter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says for a Muslim, inna amrahu kullahu lahu khair. So then we are always harvesting what is good. If it is torture, if it is any oppression, Allah will reward us. If we make it the other way, that is of the fruits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. May Allah bless you, and I'd like you to think about how we are always give the evidence and proof that we are Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, as the narration of Muslim, as-sadaqatu burhan. As-sadaqa is the evidence and proof that you truly accept everything of your deen and you want to please Allah the most. أقم الصلاة.